It's a big setup. I hope you win.
Come on.
Go, 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 go. Go, 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 go.
Before the Pied Pipers of Travel get swept up in a wave of screaming kids.
Go, 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 go.
Let's see where we're at.
Look, Mom, no hand.
Reality star Rob Mariano and monster trucker Dennis Anderson have found 24 ways
we're making some time now
to go from Southern California
now we're talking
to Africa's Victoria Falls.
There it is, right there.
Now they have a new destination.
Family jewels right there, yep, but they're not yours.
Lake Tanganyika in Zambia. At 415 miles, it's the longest freshwater lake in the world.
Man, it's a lot of work.
Rob Mariano and Dennis Anderson are circling the globe using 80 forms of transportation without repeating a single one.
Now watch out, watch where you go.
It's around the world in 80 ways.
You gotta be kidding me.
We pick up with Dennis and Rob where we last left them, at the bottom of Victoria Falls.
I can tell you right now, dude, you'd have to be crazy to go over that in a barrel.
Mr. Boston had Dennis over a barrel. The country boy was convinced Rob was dumb enough to ride the falls in a steel drum.
There it is, right there. No way.
They had a laugh, and now it's time to get their way on.
Real funny, dude.
What?
Before they can start their journey to Lake Tanganyika, they gotta get their butts out of the gorge.
This is a funicular.
Funicular? Well, this beats walking. We're walking. Jeez. Woo!
A funicular is a cable railway installed on a mountainside too steep for animals or motorized vehicles to navigate. The typical funicular is two cars attached by a steel cable. One car descends the mountain while pulling its partner back up.
Thing is getting steep, dude.
Oh, man.
The one Dennis and Rob are riding is a monocarriage funicular. There's only one car. A counterbalance weight to pull it up the slope is underneath the tracks. While the car is going up, the heavy weight is sliding down.
Oh, man. We're steeper than the waterfall.
There's one cable holding us on.
If that freaking cable broke right now,
it would be all over.
We wouldn't have to worry about another way.
Funiculars are generally safe, but in November of 2000, one caught fire. 170 passengers were on board. Only 12 made it out alive.
Wow.
Wow, the slowest roller coaster in the world, ladies and gentlemen.
Backwards.
Woo!
Yeah.
Lake Tanganyika is still 1,000 miles away. That means it's time to go shopping.
Now look at this market. Looks like you can buy anything that's made in Africa, you can get right here.
Sensory overload is the best way to describe an African market.
Look at everybody got a million fish.
If you walk through here with your mouth open, you will get flies in your mouth. Check these out. They're big old wheelbarrows. Heck yeah, dude. It's like an off-road wheelbarrow.
Dennis, hop on.
Ooh.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
What happens next is too predictable.
Dude, I bet we can race these things.
We can, dude. Hey, we want to race them.
Fast, fast, fast. Oh, this guy's good. You're with me, buddy. You're in my stable. Where are we going to race to, first
okay,
of all?
Look, what we're going to do, dude, is I think we'll race through the market from one side of the market to the other, to the next main street.
Okay.
I weigh a lot more than you do, so you were gonna have to put some extra cargo on your wheelbarrow.
Just to make it even. Okay, okay. All right. I guess it's only fair.
All right, let's do it. Let's go over here and get loaded up. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make Rob carry a crate of chickens with him too.
Oh yeah.
That's nice. Ah. if this right here is 25 pounds, you'll have to have about 35 pounds of bananas.
No way, you don't even weigh that much.
You're crazy, look at that.
I'll take one basket of chickens, and I'll take some bananas to make up the extra weight.
Okay.
Loser does the heavy lifting.
You got it. Hey, hey, how y'all doing? See that guy over there? See with the gray hat that's got B on it?
Yes.
That's Rob, and I want to beat him.
It's only taken him five countries and two continents, but Dennis finally gets it.
Halfway through the market, I want all of y'all to get out in front of him and go, whoa, and make him take the long way around, okay?
If you're gonna go against Rob, you gotta play dirty.
Yeah. All right.
Gets it. What do you want? Gets it.
Go, 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 go. Woo! Yeah, baby! Woo-hoo! Thank you, it's all for you.
Dennis's Rob block pays off.
Woo! We got it! Hey! Yeah! Woo! Yeah, baby!
You won! But what was with the roadblock?
I didn't see no roadblock.
Yeah, all these guys stopped me and made me go the other way. You learned.
Right on, man.
Okay, who wants chickens?
Yeah!
The boys have made their way north of the falls, about 10 miles from the town of Livingstone. They need to get there before they can even think about Tanganyika. Railroad tracks are always a good place to start walking.
Hear that? Yes.
You just might catch a train.
Hey, you got room for two more?
Yeah, whoever comes in can come and stop the boat.
I think what he said is one has to shovel coal and we can ride.
Okay.
So if that's the case, you're on. Remember, I won the last race.
Rob thought he was getting a free ride. Think again.
Dang. Gee. I'm gonna be attacked by a baboon if I can get in my luxury liner here. Jeez, man, this thing is beautiful.
Hot! It's hot! And it's hot. What year was this train made? How old is it?
87 years.
87?
Yes.
What's the top speed? Ah!
Can I drop you over to the hospital?
How many times you burn yourself?
Whoa,
nice. Look at it. One, yeah. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Look at that. That's a fresh one. You just did that a few weeks ago, huh?
This is a man's job.
Yeah.
The Royal Livingstone Express, number 156, was originally built in 1924. It was used to pull timber from the forest of Mulabazi to the railhead in Livingstone.
What side?
If this train could travel the 1,000 miles to Lake Tanganyika, they'd have to burn nearly a ton of coal to get there.
Nice. What does this do?
It's the best pump to test your water boiler.
Water pressure. That's the steam pressure. That's this one. What's this one?
Vacuum gauge.
The 156's engine uses coal to superheat water. A slide valve allows the high-pressure steam to power the wheels and move the train. The steam is exhausted through the chimney, causing the familiar choo-choo sound.
Oh, nice. This definitely is first class.
Come on!
How much you know about it?
Can I just do the horn again? More? Dennis must know I'm driving now. Think I'm interrupting his dinner? Ah, it's hot! Yeah, don't touch it. Everywhere you look is another landmine.
Uh-oh. Mm-hmm.
With Rob stoking the firebox, Dennis starts working the crowd.
How y'all doing?
Great.
All right. Where y'all from?
Montana.
Montana.
Yep.
Yeah, I've been to Billings, Montana. Right. I've go through Montana and do monster truck shows.
Cool.
Well, it's my first time in Africa. I'm loving this. I got my buddy up there. He's shoveling coal for us right now.
Yeah. You get to eat and he gets to shovel. Yeah.
Close it up. Hot.
Come on. See them with that body. Break that body inside.
Have you ever heard of Grave Digger?
I've heard of it because it's on your hat.
Right. Well, you saw it. Y'all from around here? Have you ever heard of Grave Digger? It's a monster truck.
No.
I jump over school buses, trains, and planes and stuff with it. I like your coat too, man. Let's see y'all.
This job is a pain in the ass, you know that? I hope you appreciate me now, Dennis.
This is beautiful back here, y'all. You know what it reminds me of? She'll be coming around that mountain when she comes. Yee-haw! She'll be on a big old steam train when she comes. Yee-haw! She'll be riding in a steam train. She'll be riding in a steam train.
What's going on?
Uh-oh. This doesn't look good.
After some fun on a funicular and an African-style wheelbarrow race, the boys' next way is proving to be a little hot.
This doesn't look good.
Looks like Rob got a little too stoked on their train into Livingstone.
Rob, what's the holdup?
Shut it down! We put too much coal in the steam engine. It built up too much pressure. Then we had to put the fire out and start all over again.
Oops. Hey! What are you doing, though, dude?
I put too much coal. I was trying to make it go fast. You better get back on. We're moving now.
That was a hell of a good way right there.
The boys finally make it to Livingstone.
All right, guys, thank you.
But Lake Tanganyika is still 1,000 long and hard miles away.
We got to go get a car.
It's time to stop riding wheelbarrows and playing with choo-choo trains.
Excuse me, do you know where you can rent a car?
You need a car.
Yeah, I want to rent a car.
We want to rent one and drive it, though. We want it.
Myself, I don't know.
Okay, thank you. Thanks for your honesty.
That's what I like about the people over here. They're honest.
There you go, there's airport transfer.
This is it. This is it.
Okay, cool.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
I'd like to rent a car. We need a vehicle, something we can drive or sell.
No problem. This is taxi.
Okay. We need to get to Lake Tanganyika. Do you know where that is?
Lake Tanganyika is in the northern part of Zambia.
How long will it take to drive there?
It will take about 2 days.
2 days in the car with you?
How about me? Okay, maybe I can't take 2 days in the car with you.
I recommend you take a car from Livingstone into Lusaka, then get a flight in Tumpulungu.
Okay.
Tumpulungu.
Tumpulungu. I saw that on the chocolate factory or something.
Let's do it. Sign us up. What do you got?
Yeah.
Cadillac, Lincoln. One midsize, something with air condition.
I've got a wonderful wagon. That's the only car left.
A wagon?
That's all you got. That's all you got. We'll take it.
What?
It's a freaking hearse.
Smells like a goat in here. God. Nah, it stinks in here too, dude.
I forgot the steering wheel's on the wrong side.
What is that smell, dude?
Come on.
God.
Put the window down.
I don't even think my window works.
Oh, man. You know how many bodies have been in here? Whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, you gotta remember, you gotta drive on the opposite side, Dennis.
Grave digger to the rescue, grave digger to the rescue.
Watch out, watch where you're going. Left, left, left!
Oh. Man, when did you stop backseat driving?
Hearses evolved from horse-drawn wagons that carted away the dead during the plagues of the Middle Ages. These carts were later customized to stack adult-sized coffins. The hearse we recognize today was developed in the 1930s. In rural areas, hearses actually doubled as ambulances. You knew your number was up if you were dispatched to the cemetery rather than the hospital.
Keep your hands on the wheel.
Don't worry about it, buddy. I got it. I'm operating this cat. Just chill.
After 2 hours in the hearse, the boys were 100 miles closer to Lake Tanganyika, halfway between Jenga Jenga and Jinga Jinga. Yes, those are real places.
Coming into another little shanty town here.
Okay, do you want to stop and get some chickens there? We might need them for later.
In these parts, farm animals are money. They're thinking a couple of live chickens might grease a wheel somewhere down the road.
Dennis, you coming?
Yeah, we're gonna get a turkey.
I don't see why not. Wanna get a duck?
No, we ain't got no water.
How much are the birds? How much is this one?
Look at the guineas. Look at the pair of guineas right here. I'd like the goat.
How much for the goat? 150?
Yes.
150 for the goat.
How much is that in Americans?
$30.
What, $30? That's going price at home for him, too, really.
Okay, one goat and one chicken, how much? 200?
200,000. That guinea's gonna be sad without the other one.
Give him another 50 if
here,
you wanna get two
here,
of them.
Put that in there.
Come on.
Take that. Easy there, Hot Rod. Yeah, it's okay, you're good.
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa.
Okay, hey, buddy. Fresh goats, fresh fish, look at it. Everybody around here is hungry. But then we need a car seat for the kids.
Oh, kid Billy Goat, I get the joke.
Yeah, we need a car seat for the kid.
I want to name him Vinny.
I want him to ride up here. Dude, I'm telling you, he would ride on your lap and lay down if you just rub him and hold him. And
you want to sit here and I'll drive and you can hold him?
Nah, it's okay.
Yeah.
This thing smells like in here. Goats, guineas, and dead bodies.
What's up with the guinea hens?
Guineas are cool. They're better than watchdogs when you've got them around your house.
No, those birds are dumb.
Oh, Vinny.
Oh, no.
That's my only change of clothes I got.
Oh, no, he's coming out.
Vinny, did you pee on us back here, dude?
Oh, stop, stop.
Coming up.
That's the family jewels right there.
So far on this trip, Dennis and Rob have scaled Victoria Falls in a funicular.
Wow, the slowest roller coaster in the world.
Raced wheelbarrows.
Block him off, block him off, block him off.
And rode a steam train on their way to the shores of Lake Tanganyika. Now they're putting down some real miles in a rental body buggy.
Oh, no.
Vinny, did you pee on us back here, dude?
Oh, stop, stop.
That's my only change of clothes I got. Vinny's ass has got to go now. Vinny.
Their new pets have turned the hearse into a barn.
Hey, how y'all doing?
Time to rethink their investment.
We have a goat and some hens.
Guineas. We got some guineas. It's free. We're gonna give it to you.
No. We're gonna give you some stuff, and it'll be for the whole family. Two guineas and a goat. The goat's name is Vinny. You gotta hold that.
Oh yeah, he really liked that. Oh dear, we lost one. Oh, he's gone.
Y'all gonna love Vinny, okay?
Bye, Vinny. All right, bye-bye.
All right.
Bye, Vinny, we'll miss you. He was a good goat.
He's gonna be a good goat right down their throat now.
After delivering dinner,
oh man, this is nice over here.
Rob gets behind the wheel. Never a good thing.
I can't see. Dude, we're stuck behind this truck for a while. Oh, I want to gamble.
Yeah, go ahead. Be the big guy there and kill yourself. Way easy. Your car's sick in a minute. You keep weaving back and forth.
How am I looking?
You're looking good. Go for it.
Oh,
go.
Whoa. Sorry.
Go ahead. Gamble both of our lives, Rob.
Don't be such a baby. Can you see on that side? Is anybody coming?
Looks like it's pretty. No.
You want to gamble?
Yeah, not with that.
No.
Oh, that was close.
Woo!
And there comes another one.
Dude, why are you...
Man, okay. I could have made it.
I could have totally made it.
We're getting into the hills, buddy.
This is a long trip.
You want me to drive so you can take a little nap there, sweetheart?
Go yourself.
Near the halfway point of their trip, we set the boys up with a tour you won't find in the local travel brochures. The open pit Kagem mine produces over 30 million carats of emeralds per year, stones that were created over 450 million years ago.
This is where they bring all the emeralds after they find them in the field and like divvy them up?
That's great.
Miners pulled a 2.5-pound emerald out of the mine. That cost you about $9 million on the open market. So the company takes security very seriously.
It's a radio microphone.
Jeez.
Dude, this is awesome. You must be new because you got not the really good ones, huh?
Yeah.
It's pretty complex, all of it, but you guys have it down to a science, it looks like. 200 different grades. If I wanted to buy one of these, how much would that cost me?
$20,000. Oh, $20,000? Oh, yeah, that's more like it. Yeah.
Maybe the wife will like that new bathrobe for Christmas instead, but the boys head out to play with some trucks. Emeralds are nice, but these 6x6 dump trucks are mucho macho. These brutes can haul 30 tons of dirt in a single load, and it takes a ton of dirt to get 1 gram of emerald out of this mine.
I'm gonna play with a little toy here. This is my life-size Tonka truck.
Hey, what can I say, man? This is up my alley, dude. This is a monster truck.
Okay, how do I drive this thing?
Get out of the way!
Man, I hope there's no trucks coming the other way. Better slow down. It's a steep turn.
Yee-haw! Ha-ha! This haul road right here is a mess, man. These guys are looking at us like we're crazy.
They're literally down there with their hands and shovels and picks mining emeralds.
We gotta get in here and try this, dude. We need to try to find one.
There we go. That's a way.
After dropping 100 feet into this money pit, the real work begins.
So explain what's going on here.
This is the real geology. This is where the emeralds are found. It's hand done, so they don't damage any of the stones, and found within this black rock.
So basically, you dig this huge hole in the center of the earth to get to this rock, and then once you get to this rock, you start doing it by hand.
Yes. That's right, Rob. The company removed 30 million tons of dirt before getting into the money, but the payoff is big. Last year, these miners took about 33 million carats of the green gemstones. At a going price of $42 a carat, that's over $1 billion. You're not gonna win that on Survivor.
Can we get in there and try it?
For sure.
I bet you guys would like a break, huh? You want a break?
Let them watch us for a while. All right, I'm doing this right here for my beautiful wife, Carissa, at home, baby.
I hope she gets an emerald and not a black rock.
I'll tell you what, this, if you don't know what you're doing, you can waste a lot of time.
I still don't know what I'm doing, really.
Uh-oh, jackpot, look at that, baby. Look at that.
Let me see it.
You can see it from there. Look at that beautiful emerald right there.
Oh, ding.
Please, gentlemen, could you put it in the box, please?
In the box?
Yes, in the box.
We can't take these with us?
Nobody can handle this, the stones.
Oh, man!
Please, put it in the box, and I want to close the box. Gentlemen, please.
Oh, man.
I want to close the box.
You're going to get a shot, dude. Knock it off.
Coming up.
I got a plan for little Dennis's doll. Bye-bye! Think you're funny, don't you, boy?
The boys are in the Kagan Emerald Mine.
Uh-oh, jackpot, look at that, baby. Look at that.
And Dennis found himself a hot rock.
Let me see it.
Look at that beautiful emerald right there.
Up, ding.
And now he and Rob are in hot water.
Just please put it in the box, and I want to close the box. Gentlemen, please.
Oh, man.
Because
he wants to close the box.
Yeah. See that, right?
Well, that's, can you mark my name on this one?
Would you put it in the box, please?
You're too serious, yeah. Thank you.
You're gonna get a shot, dude. Knock it off. He's got her in lockdown, buddy.
If they did manage to get shot,
we need to pass security.
It wouldn't be a flesh wound.
Look at that cannon. Jeez.
Oh, man, that's no joke.
They're not leaving without a top-to-bottom shakedown.
Okay. Open my mouth?
Yes. Yes, baby. What's okay.
Even though it's their first date,
my ears? It's awful thorough. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Dennis's guard gets to third base.
Whoa, whoa. Hey.
Woo. That's the family jewels right there. Yep, but they're not yours. Jeez.
Move your shoes.
Son of a. All right, hold my bow.
No joke, dude. They take their security serious.
Shut up, Rob. I know that, okay?
Why are you telling me to shut up?
Because I got the security man right here in front of me.
Keep it up, and I'll go put a rock in your pocket.
All right.
You'll be stuck in Zambia.
Thank you.
I think he needs to get him a job at night doing massages. What do you think, Rob? How'd that feel?
You should wait till we're out of here before you start making fun of the man.
After 7 hours in a death-defying hearse,
go for it.
Oh, whoa.
Sorry.
And some touchy-feely with security guards, Dennis and Rob are still looking at 700 miles before they can dip their toes in Lake Tanganyika. They're back in Blackie, but starting to get buggy.
Don't worry, Rob, I got you back. I got you back.
Right here's little D.
I'm gonna throw that thing out the window.
Dennis is playing with an early prototype for a new Dennis Anderson action figure.
So help me God, dude, if you break his freaking arm. Damn it.
Coming down.
Back it down.
Put the toys away, dude. We're at the police checkpoint.
Ah.
Hello.
Hey.
Yep, we got a fresh one back here.
Yeah, we got a dip.
No, we got a fresh one in the back. Yeah.
Don't mess around.
Hey!
That was funny.
30 miles outside of Lusaka, the boy sees something unusual. Road construction. The 1.5 million mile road system is only 30% paved.
I got a plan for little Dennis's doll. Bye-bye.
A couple of steamrollers at a construction site gets the competitive juices flowing again.
All right, you ready to do this? Let's do it, Let's pretty go. Boy. You're history, Rob.
Let's go to that white truck down there.
Okay, all right, here's the deal. The loser's gonna be the banana bitch for the day.
The what?
The banana bitch.
What's that?
You know what, never mind. Don't worry about it. I'm gonna win anyway.
Maybe it's the hearse or spending too much time with Rob.
Start him up, you ready?
But Tennis is starting to have some strange fantasies.
Yeah, think you're funny, don't you, boy?
All right, you ready to do this?
Ready to do this?
All right, you ready to do this?
Back to reality, Dennis has to find a way to beat Mr. Reality, who's back to his old tricks.
Hey, look what I got. Oh, I got your little dolly.
Come on, dude. Rob, you freaking ass. Oh, man, little D, baby. That's all right. I got nitrous for you right here, buddy. Yeah, you're lucky I didn't run you over, too.
Oh, and that's another way.
Then what'd you do, get out and get him? Yeah. Yeah, that's my man right here. It's little D.
Come on, enough screwing around.
Only a few miles from the airport at Lusaka.
Okay. So call the airline and find out who flies up to Mbala.
Dennis gets on the horn to book their next way.
Airport?
Hello? Hey, what airline flies to
Mbala?
Mbala? Mbala.
Not Mbala. Mbala.
Mbala.
Is it a she or a he?
It's a he.
Ask her if she...
I think. I'm not sure. Might be a shim. Look, there's no commercial flights.
Let's just go there. We'll be able to get more done in person anyway.
All right. Thank you, sir, or ma'am, or... Yeah, thank you.
Oh, dude.
Hope it's a long time before I ride one of those again.
We got the boys a couple of seats on a cargo plane, but this time they have to work before they ride.
Look it, it must be for like a relief flight.
Yeah, it is. Some kind of a solar or something another in here.
Have you ever driven one of these?
Yeah.
You have?
Yeah.
Okay, well then I guess I get to drive it.
No, you don't. You're so full of crap. I got to the bottom.
The plane's right there. Do you let me drive it?
Yeah, I'll let you drive it.
All right, let me start it up. How do I run this thing?
No, you know everything. Go ahead, help yourself there, Hot Rod.
Never mind, I'll figure it out.
Help yourself, buddy. There you go.
I got it.
Hey, 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 hey! Take it easy, dude. Dumbass. What an idiot, man.
Baggage carts pulled by tractors and tugs were first put into use in the 1930s to speed up the loading and unloading of cargo. But technology doesn't always mean efficiency. The state-of-the-art baggage system at Denver Airport uses 17 miles of track that operates at speeds up to 25 miles an hour. This innovative system has never worked properly.
Easy, don't run into the plane. Turn it off. Dude, you're scary on stuff just because you really don't know what you're doing.
50 feet in a luggage carrier? Since they're working so hard, we'll give it to them.
All right, here you go, Rob. Yeah. There you go. Whoa, come back.
Here you go.
Don't bust them. You know, we weren't supposed to do the whole job anyway, man. We're just supposed to help, Rob.
We're getting a free ride.
What took 10 hours in a hearse to cover, the cargo plane will manage in a little over an hour. And since it's not a commercial jet or a vintage fighter plane, it counts as a way. They're up to six on this leg of their journey around the world.
All right, and that was another way.
Coming up.
All right, this is our first Oompa Noompa, is that how you say it? Oompa Luma wire car race. Dennis Anderson, four-time world champ against Boston Rob.
Hey, go, 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 go!
After covering 1,000 miles through Zambia, Dennis and Rob are a few miles from the shores of their target destination, Lake Tanganyika.
This is like the heart of an African town in the middle of, well, I guess we're not nowhere, we're somewhere.
What is it? What is the name of this place? Mongolung. Mongolung.
Oompulungu.
Oompulungu. Oompulungu. Oompulungu.
Look at this. What is that?
Look at that big one right there, dude. That's the grave digger right here.
Big kids Dennis and Rob are fascinated by what the little kids are playing with. Wire cars.
Look, it's got steering and everything. Dennis.
Yeah, this is cool, man.
You think we can make a real big one that we can ride in?
I think so, dude. We need some bigger wire. We want to build something big enough so we can ride in them.
Where'd you get the wire?
How y'all doing?
Look at this is the wire they use right here. We can use this for a frame.
Okay.
You're not going to find these power tools at your local hardware store.
That's a welder? Does that work? Can you weld with it?
Yeah, it works.
All right, well, then you can do the welding.
I don't know, dude. I'm scared of that thing.
I don't think safety is a high priority. See if he's got a ground on that. All right, everybody, back up.
Everybody, listen to Rob. This is Bossy Rob, okay? He's the boss.
Watch out before you get hurt, too.
Children in Zambia build these wire cars because traditional toys are not available. A smart kid can build them in a couple of hours, and they only cost about 50 cents.
See, I'm gonna make me a little window like this, so I got me a roof over me.
So I'm gonna go try to find some wheels.
Okay. I don't know what the I'm doing. I smell alcohol and wires burning.
Is he using zip ties?
I'm gonna make this baby like a black and green wrecking machine. There we go.
Okay, it looks pretty good.
No, hey, ho, ease up on the red now. Wait. Seriously,
No.
Is that red?
No, this is orange.
Huh?
It's orange.
All right, I need one of them.
Why?
Let me see. You because that one's got the wrong cap on it. Put me one red mark across here. Oh, yeah.
Can I have a piece?
No. It's for the black and green wrecking machine, Rob.
You guys ready? You ready to push me and go fast? We got to race from here down to the light pole past the hardware store.
Which one? The one leaning over or the next one?
The one after.
All right, this is our first Oompa Noompa. Is that how you say it? Oompa Luma Nationals here in Africa.
wire car race. Dennis Anderson, four-time world champ against Boston Rob.
It's a big setup. I hope you win.
Come on, go, 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 go. Come on, come on. Ha, ha, go, 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 go.
To the finish.
No, you didn't. I got across it first.
Right, here's the pole.
Right here.
Oh, my goodness. Ooh.
Cheaters, 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 cheaters.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, Dennis, that's another way.
With my team. Yeah.
The race ended like so many others, with Rob the victor and Dennis trying foul play.
Let's go. Have fun with the cars.
The kids ride off with a couple of new wire cars.
Don't break it.
While Dennis and Rob head down the road, they can pat themselves on their backs because they finally reached their destination, Lake Tanganyika.
This is the lake, dude. Look at it. This is Lake Tanganyika.
This is pretty big, man. One of my goals, man, when we were doing this mission, you know, around the world in 80 ways is Africa. When I'm watching TV all the time, man, I see all the culture of people, the crafts and stuff that they build with their hands and how they live off the land. We work for all these extras. These people, they work for survival over here. And that's pretty impressive to me.
Came all this way so you could have a dance party.
Dennis and I are taking our relationship one step at a time. But you know what? It's a learning experience, and we're growing, and it's a bit like a roller coaster ride.
I'm learning Rob still, but you got to build some relationship. You're riding 400 miles in a hearse. You got to put up some kind of craft.
I'm going to throw that thing out the window.
You know, the man that died didn't even ride that far in it.
I got to tell you, I'm looking forward to getting onto Lake Tanganyika and a little change of scenery.
Another chapter in the adventure is over, with Rob and Dennis bagging nine different ways. A funicular carried them up to a wheelbarrow.
Go, 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 go!
Woo-hoo! Which got them on a train.
This job is a pain in the ass, you know that?
They stopped off for some dump trucks, got on a big roll that brought them to a hearse, then rode a baggage tug to a cargo plane, which landed them in a wire car race that ended at the lake. Only 47 more ways until the world is theirs.